sure all of us have once laid our eyes on something so tempting, something so irresistible that we feel like we can't go on in life without getting it. You don't care whether it is right or wrong, you just want it in your hands. This something varies from person to person. For some, it can be some snack from the canteen, and for others, it can be something their parents probably wouldn't approve of, like an item from a video game, for example. Gandhi once said this famous quote, "The world has enough for everyone's need, but not for everyone's greed." For me, this quote really emphasizes the difference between the living situations of the rich and the poor. Let's go back to the situation mentioned earlier. If you people were to buy a video game using the precious hard-earned allowance that you saved up, all you would get is the game and a possible beating from your parents. But if a poor person were to buy this video game, odds are that they probably can't afford it, and even if they could, they'll probably be starving for the entire week. So, what exactly is causing these poor people to stay poor or go even poorer? There are a lot of factors causing this issue, and I'll talk about the major ones. The first one I'll touch on is education. The level of education a person receives is often proportional to the level of their skill. With a higher level of education, a person often has more advanced skills that few workers are able to offer, justifying a higher pay. People in poverty are trapped inside this vicious cycle where they will never escape because to get good education, you need money, and to get money, you need a well-paying job, and to get a well-paying job, you need good education. So the cycle just keeps going on and on. Although there are usually policies of free education in developed nations, levels of education received by each individual still differ, not because of financial ability, but innate qualities like intelligence, drive, and personal ability. So these policies don't really break people out of the cycle. The next reason is the advancement of technology. As the technology of the world progresses, they begin to eliminate the need for human power. In many jobs, such as packaging and manufacturing, the machineries are becoming more and more efficient. Hence, jobs involving repetitive tasks have largely been eliminated. This really brings up the question, is the advancement of technology really the advancement of humanity? Now, on to the final cause, gender. The gender wage gap still persists to this day, and women make 82 cents for every dollar a man makes. This is largely because there are more men in senior roles than women. At the heart of the problem is an assumption that senior jobs require long hours and constant availability, and so cannot be done flexibly or part-time. At this point, you're probably wondering, why do I need to care about poverty? What's the point of listening to the rest of this lecture? Well, imagine one day, as you're walking home, you pass a pond where you see a little girl drowning. You look around in panic. Where are her parents? But no one is around. Only you. The pond is so shallow enough so you can save her without drowning, but deep enough that she'll drown if you don't help her. But you're wearing your brand new pair of Jordans today. Surely you wouldn't want to ruin them, right? In this situation, what would you do? Saver or keep walking? If your answer is the saver, which I hope it is, then why not save billions of others drowning in the same pond by learning more about poverty?